Hello, hello, you guys. Welcome to my channel and welcome to Everyday Inspiration. Every few months, it's been every other month pretty much, but I think we had a weird two month gap in there just because summer's crazy. A bunch of amazing ladies take a photo from their everyday life, one of them, share it with the group, and then they use that as inspiration to create a page. They invited me, they're inviting guests every month that they do it this year, and we can stay on. So I was one of the guests in February, so I'm still here. but we invited, or they, I should say they, I did not choose, even though I would have. They invited Janet to play along for September, and she shared this lovely photo. And Rebecca made the comment about how it's fall meets spring, it's perfect. So I'm enjoying getting caught up on the Blank to Bold class that Janet and MK are hosting, and I decided to take one of our first homeworks and use that as a fall meets spring type of thing. I'm not going to tell you all the details and tips and stuff of how I made this lovely pattern paper, but it's from the class, but I thought it was very fall meets spring because I've got foliage, leaves, some richer colors, and then I've got this pop of pink, which the colors then made me think of, I kind of brought the colors in thinking of the Bow Bunny collection, is it Beautiful Things, which have some very rich tones and very kind of fall-esque with some of the oranges and the yellows, but very bright at the same time. So that's what it made me think of. And then it made me, Janet's photo made me think of all the photos I have of my son playing with dandelions, which I think I've actually scrapped all the ones of him picking dandelions, but I had this one of him holding one of these baby, I think they're violets. I don't know. What are they called? I don't remember. Oh, Lily of the Valley, maybe? I can't remember. They grow randomly wild in our yard all the time. And actually this year there's not as many, but I think my husband sprayed for them. He used to get so excited when he see the purple flowers or the blue flowers. So he's gently holding one. And so I thought this would be a good photo for this. So I grabbed colors kind of based on this. The photo made me think of this and all of that. And I like this fall meets spring-esque thing. So I'm going to create a layout based on the Blank to Bold class that then this was our homework for. So unfortunately, you're not going to see a ton of process with that. Or you'll see bits. But I just wanted to show you the paper before I apparently am ripping it up. I did all this work. MK is going to make me rip it up. Just want to, yeah. But this was really fun and it was something fun to do. I forget that, I mean, I'm not an expert in mixed media, but I'm not a beginner. But I forget that just playing with stamps and colors and is kind of therapeutic and fun. And it's kind of a nice break from creating layouts and everything just to create and not film. So I created this and I really like the way it turned out. I might even add some rose gold splatters because there's rose gold, and I think this is rose gold, yes. There is rose gold elements in this Bow Bunny collection. So I think I'm going to add some rose gold splatters to this background really quick. Oh yeah, this one has a bead in it. You're supposed to shake it. And this is Kaiser Craft Mist rose gold iridescent spray. So I'm going to just splatter on it and then I'll let that dry. I actually just did the packaging technique. So the colors I used, if you want to know, I did some picked raspberry for the packaging technique that I added. I didn't necessarily need to add that, but I really liked the idea of having these kind of richer fall tones and then this pop of bright. And then I have all the pink fresh inks, the little cubes, which did they discontinue those? I don't remember. I remember that at one point they were all on clearance and I grabbed a bunch of them. I used Tidal Pond, Persimmon, and ballet slipper. And then distressed inks, I have a few little cubes of just the inks. Otherwise, I love oxides. So I think I might try to get a few more just distressed inks. And I like this size because I don't use them as much because I'm really an oxide person. I really love the oxides. I love the creaminess of them. I love being able to manipulate them with water. So they are definitely my favorite because I'm not a huge stamp ink person, so I don't necessarily, and I have archivals for when I want my crisp stuff, but I have Dried Marigold and Stormy Skies. And I thought those matched the Beau Bunny collection the best to what I think it did. So yeah. Wow! I didn't want that to come off. A dart. We have dart wars around our house a lot. Okay, so we're going to, and it can go everywhere because we're making a patterned paper, not a background. That's what MK kept reminding us. It was a patterned paper, not a background. Don't have to worry about placement of photos. It's a patterned paper, not a background. I like adding the splatters. Yes. Great. And I like that they're a color too. That's very close to this orangey red color. So it really brings that out. The persimmon, it matches. It's really close to that color. So, okay. I'm gonna let that dry. So then I get my iridescence, which I already have a little bit. Ooh, and I love it. And then I will start doing the other part of the layout, and I will check back in with you as I go. So, all right. And make sure you check out everybody else who's playing with Everyday Inspiration down below. Okay, be right back. All right, I want to show you what I've got so far. I've watched most of the class that I missed from Blank to Bold. And yeah, this is what I've got so far. So this was all taught in the class, which is awesome. MK and Janet are brilliant. And like I said, things I never thought of before. And I just, yeah. So I have my base all set. I've matted my photo twice on that scrap of patterned paper I had. I'll probably do a large font title because they suggested 2 to 3 photos and I only did one. I'm a bad student. They also told us to grab white cardstock. I have this turquoise, but I did tuck white underneath there so my white edge was a little bit bigger, and then I'm glad that some of this poked out just because I'm horrible at planning ripping and everything. So that all worked out too. And then I have all my embellishments and a random scrap of white piece of cardstock here. I have my shimmer pen I still can use. They suggested fibers or a texture of some kind. I don't know if I'm going to. I could get some tissue paper and add that as a layer underneath here too. That actually might be good. I think I'm going to do that, or even under my photo. Otherwise I don't think I'm going to do fibers or anything. So I'm going to add tissue paper under my photo just to give it a nice soft edge, and then we'll start embellishing, but I'm going to go wash my blending brushes off real fast, so be back. All right, I've been playing around with embellishments and I've decided to go with these, I believe. So I'm gonna start gluing these down. And then I remembered the prompt for today for Scraptember is rainbows. And yeah, I could be like, I've got rainbow colors. No, I'm not gonna do that. Where's my little hexagons? I have also these stickers I could add, and these little hexagons. We might add these little hexagons. But anyway, the prompt is rainbow, and what I thought is I could add a rainbow into my stamping really quick with some antique linen because it'll kind of go with like this crafty colored tissue paper that I've added everywhere. So yeah, I'm going to add that so that way we've got the prompt as well, but the Blank to Bold class has been so much fun, even though I'm so behind. I'm really liking the things that they're teaching. Things that, like I said, I'm not an expert in mixed media, by any means, but just like things that like, duh, that's amazing. Like great tips and great ideas to be had by all. Seriously. Okay, I didn't glue any of this down. It's all just sitting here. So we're gonna cut off the rest of that. Oh, I'm gonna tuck that there. Because then that way it's used. Doesn't hurt anything. Kind of fills this out a little more. Doesn't really cover up my stamping. Keep that for future. Half circle butterfly. Okay. Yeah, do I want... Oh good, they're a lot smaller than they looked. I thought they were gonna be this giant. No, they are much smaller than they look. And some of these. Okay, and I got three left. Where am I gonna put them? We'll save them, I guess. I've got this tiny little I just want the rainbow. No one's ever gonna know. Except for now you guys, because I just showed you that I'm adding it now. So I've got the prompt accomplished. And I've got everything else done. This was, like I said, really good class, really good inspiration, Janet. Thank you on both ends, on the class and on your photo. And some fun ladies that have created pages will be down below. So make sure you guys go check all of them out for everyday inspiration. Thank you again so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.